Let's say you just started to learn web development. You already have some foundation with HTML and JavaScript, and you are wondering how to move forward. Which one to choose from the two most popular front-end libraries, React and Vue? Well, the short answer is, it doesn't really matter. There's a bunch of videos out there highlighting the differences, but the two libraries and their ecosystem are so close to each other that the development experience is basically the same. What is certainly not a difference is performance and their capabilities. They can be used both for a small hobby project and a professional large-scale application. The main difference is syntax, but how you structure your code, how you reason about code, and what patterns you use are essentially the same. So if you're starting to learn one of these, why not start with both React and Vue and see which one fits you better? I'm Hunor, and in this video, we are going through the main patterns side by side with React and Vue as we create a list application and a simple counter application. We are going to see how to compose applications from components, how to make them data-driven, how to handle user interaction, and finally, we are going to finish with how can you create your own project and start developing your app. So let's get into it. Both React and Vue are component-based. This means that every website built with these technologies are broken down into smaller meaningful bits, components. This makes the code more manageable. Instead of having massive files, you end up with smaller ones. They are easier to navigate, reason about, and developers can work on different parts of the website without interfering with each other too much. For example, let's imagine that this is a huge HTML file with thousands of lines and it became hard to understand. Regardless if you're using React and Vue, we would break this up into components. Here the menu section and the content section both make sense on their own, so we can move them into separate components and we only keep a reference to them in the main file. This way, we end up with pieces that are not only easier to overview, but easier to maintain as well. So how do components look like in React and Vue? To show this, we create a very simple cart component both with React and Vue. We are going to see that React and Vue took a different path in the syntax of a component, but the patterns and possibilities are still quite similar. In React, a component is basically a JavaScript function that provides something that looks like HTML. Now this might look a bit confusing, because by default in JavaScript it is not possible to return HTML from a function, and this would give a syntax error. But you don't have to worry about that. When you work with React, and you have the appropriate tooling, then this is possible, and you can even assign pieces of HTML to JavaScript variables, and pass them around like any other data. The rest is pure JavaScript here. The HTML parts are not exactly HTML here either. One of the small differences you might already see is that in JavaScript, the class keyword is reserved, so when you assign a CSS class to an HTML tag, you need to use the class name keyword instead. There are some small differences like that, but the tooling will always let you know if something is wrong. So React is a mix of JavaScript and HTML, but when it comes to CSS, it still lives in separate CSS files. There are ways to define CSS in JavaScript, but this is the default. This leaves us with the problem CSS has, that it is global, and even if you define separate CSS files for each component, you still need to figure out a method with naming or in other ways to not let the style of a component interfere with the other components. Now let's see how the same component looks like with Vue. Vue has a different approach. It uses .vue files, which are also called single file components. In Vue, for each component, we have an HTML, CSS, and JavaScript part in one single file, but in separate sections. In our case, as we don't have a logic yet, we can even leave out the script part and only have a template and the style. Here we use proper HTML syntax. You can assign a CSS class normally with the class keyword. Except that here we don't do that because Vue took an extra step with handling CSS and they introduced scoped CSS. Scoped CSS only affects the HTML tags that belong to the component, so with Vue, you don't have to worry about global CSS anymore. So that's what a component looks like. But how do we connect them? Projects usually consist of many components. There's always a root component. This is usually a high-level skeleton of the page itself that rather contains the logic and state than the layout, and it delegates the details to lower levels. And as we go deeper into the child components, we see more and more actual HTML and CSS. To see how they are connected, let's have another component that we use our cart component as a child. Reusability is one of the greatest features of components. To showcase that, we start to build a list application that will include two cards. So how can we put this into code? Both in React and Vue, we can include the child component in our HTML piece as if it was a custom HTML tag. It's easy to spot them. By convention, the names of components start with a capital letter and are in Apple camel case. In both cases, we have to import the card component before we can use it. This is a bit different. In React, we simply import it at the top of the file. In Vue, though, first we have to define the script section for our component. This is JavaScript. So here we can also import our child component, but then we also need to export an object to register it as a child. This exported object acts as a companion for our template. We are going to have multiple things here. And whenever in the template there's a variable, method, or child component, Vue will look it up in this object. If you are new to JavaScript and this syntax is confusing you, this is a shorthand for a key-value pair, where the key has the same name as the value passed in. Over time, this companion object will grow, and it gets more complicated. But keep in mind that this is just a JavaScript object. So we connected two components, but now we have the very same card twice. It would make much more sense to have different titles and different descriptions in the two separate cards. To customize components, we can pass on values to them from their parents. We can pass on props to our child components as if they were custom HTML attributes. If we want to pass on a text, this has the same syntax both in React and Vue. The receiving side is different. In React, the props gets passed on as an attribute to the function that's responsible for rendering the component. Be aware that here we do not have a separate title and description attribute, but we have a single props attribute that is an object containing all the values the parent passed on. Then we can use these values in HTML with binding. Binding basically opens a window to JavaScript in HTML. In React, binding is with curly brackets. Any expression within curly brackets gets evaluated, and the result gets injected into the page. Vue is a bit different. Here we have to define in our companion object what values this component should receive. Then again, we can use binding in our template in a similar way as we did in React, except that here we use double curly brackets instead of single ones. Different syntax, same thing. With this knowledge, we can already build a static page, but things get more interesting when they are interactive. Let's talk about how interaction works and create a counter that we can increase and decrease. Interaction comes in pair with state management. First, we make the component data-driven, then with event handlers, we change our data. Let's start with Vue now. With Vue, we define a data option in our companion object that will represent our state. The data option is essentially an object that contains every variable that changes over time with their initial values. But for technical reasons, it should be defined as a function that returns this object. Here, this object will only have one property called counter with the default value 0, but in more complicated components, we would have multiple properties here. Once we have this value in the data option, we can bind it to our template the same way as we did with props with double curly brackets. And then we come to the interaction part, where we define an event handler for the button that will change our data. Here the syntax starts with the at sign, then the event's name, then in quotation marks we can define a JavaScript expression or inline function or set a method name that shall be called to handle the event. One of the beauties of Vue is that it's smart enough to know that once a data option has changed, it should update the UI. We don't have to explicitly ask Vue to re-render the UI or call any function. Just change a value and the rest is automatic. React is more complicated. To understand React's state, we need to understand React's re-rendering cycle. Whenever we change a state, we expect that the UI will update to reflect these changes. This update will happen by rerunning the Vue function that defines the component. But if we have our state inside a function as a variable, this would, of course, reset that variable. To solve this problem, React introduced hooks. With hooks, we reach out from the component's rendering function to a separate space. The useState hook is one of them. It keeps track of our state. It takes an initial value and provides us with the latest value at any time and the function that we can use to change the value. Then we combine the value with single curly brackets and bind an inline function to the onClick attribute to call the setter function. While Vue accepts inline expressions as event handlers, React only accepts inline functions and function references here. Note the subtle syntactical differences. In Vue, we prefix the attribute name with the at sign, and the attribute value is in quotation marks. In React, binding is a bit more consistent, and we bind the attribute value the same way as we bind the content of an HTML tag, with curly brackets. If you want to make things a bit nicer, we can replace our inline functions and expressions with references. Usually our event handlers are more complicated and they do not fit in one line. In React, we can define these functions inside our component function, and in Vue, we can create methods in our companion object. Methods in Vue have one extra trick though. Whenever we refer to anything from the companion object, we need to prefix it with the this keyword. Now that we know how to make our components data-driven, how about we conditionally style an HTML element based on our data? If the counter turns negative, let's show it in a different color. For this, we combine the inline style attribute of an HTML tag. This value, in both cases, will be a JavaScript object where we can set the CSS properties. The syntax of binding the style attribute or any other attributes is slightly different again. In React, as in any other case, we open a window to JavaScript with single curly brackets. Don't get confused by the double curly brackets here. The outer curly brackets are the binding itself, and the inner curly brackets belong to the JavaScript object. In Vue, whenever we bind the value of an HTML attribute, we prefix its key with a colon, then set the value of an attribute within quotation marks. To summarize, there are three different kinds of binding. We can bind the content of an HTML element, we can bind an attribute of an HTML tag, and we can bind an event handler. In React, these follow the same pattern with single curly brackets. In Vue, it depends on the case. To avoid having a massive style object defined within the attribute value, we can also pre-calculate it, then bind it. In React, we can define a regular JavaScript object in the component function that we can bind to the style attribute. In Vue, we can define a new computed property in our companion object. Computed properties appear to be a function but behave like a read-only value, that we can also bind just like a prop or a data. Another typical scenario you might face is conditional rendering. Let's say that instead of highlighting the negative numbers, we show a label to state that the number is too low. In React, we can use curly brackets again in our HTML part to open a window to JavaScript and write a JavaScript expression. This expression either resolves to false if the first part of the condition is false, or it resolves in the second part, that is the paragraph showing our text. Luckily in the first case, if it resolves to false, then React will simply ignore it. Hence we have conditional rendering. In Vue, this is a bit more sophisticated. In Vue, they introduce directives that appear as HTML attributes and alter the rendering of the component. To the vif directive, we can bind a condition and we can conditionally render a tag. In a similar fashion, we can render a list based on data. In our previous app, instead of rendering exactly two children with hard-coded values, we can render a list of cards based on an array. In this example, we use the state and the data option to store the metadata of our cards, then we turn it into a list of HTML tags. In React, we open a window to JavaScript with curly brackets, then map our array into child components. In Vue, we can use the v4 directive. Note how we use attribute bindings here as well. We already saw click events, but how about user inputs? What if we want to add a new card with a title and description set by the user? In Vue, this is fairly simple. Once we set our title and description properties in the data option, we can use the vmodel directive to make a two-way link between the data option and the input field. If either the data option property or the input field value changes, data will stay in sync automatically. In React, there's no two-way binding though. We have to bind both the state to the input field and an event handler to keep the state up to date after every keystroke. So far, we have our app component that generates a list of card components. To tie this piece together, let's add our new card component to the bottom of our list so we can add a new card. Our data generating the cards is in the root component, and we saw that our structure is top to bottom. The parent passes on props to the children and not the other way around. How can then a child tell the parent to add the new card? For this, in React, we define callbacks. We pass on a function as a prop to the children, assuming that they will call it once the new item is added. Because the function itself is defined inside a parent, it has access to the setter of the card list. And because it has been passed on to the children, they can also call it. In Vue, we don't pass around functions. Instead, we define custom events. Like a button can trigger a click event, a component can also trigger a custom event, like add card. The function that adds a new item to the list is defined in the parent, but instead of passing it on to the child, we bind it as an event handler to a custom event. And in the child, instead of calling a function that we received from someone else, we emit an event and let the parent decide how to handle it. So those were the main patterns and concepts you need to start off development. But how do you actually start a project? Both React and Vue come with a command line tool that helps you set up and run things. They both require Node on your computer, so if you don't have it already, go to nodejs.org and install it first. Then to create a React project, go to your terminal and run npx create react app my app. If you want to create a Vue project, first you need to install Vue CLI with npm install -g Vue CLI. This one you only need to run once, and then to create a project you run vue create my app. Both these commands create an initial project skeleton with an example app. If you explore them, you will find an app component in both projects. This is the root component of the project implementing some of the patterns we discussed. The projects also come with a README file that explains how to start a live preview during development. First, navigate to the projects folder in your terminal, then type npm start for React and npm run serve for Vue. This will open a browser or provide you a link where you can see how the initial project looks like. But it's not only a still shot. Till you don't stop the script, any changes you make with the project will be lively updated in your browser. Now you have every tool to start your own project, and over time your project will get more complex. They might have multiple pages and then you add the router. Or you need a centralized data storage and you start using Redux for React or Vuex for Vue. While they are not the same, they share a lot of similarities, but that's part of another course. After pointing out the similarities between how you build up a React and Vue application, I have to mention a few differences that actually matter. React is still more popular. While Vue's popularity is rising, at this point it's still easier to find a job or find an answer to your questions if you're using React. On the other hand, Vue is a more recent technology that learned from its predecessors like React, resulting in a few nice touches that feel more convenient for developers. Vue also has nicer documentation, and while there's no question out there for React that you won't be able to answer with a Google search, it might be easier to start with Vue if you never used either of these technologies before. One nice thing you can do with Vue and cannot with React is replacing the templating language from HTML to PUG, ending up with a more condensed template. On the other hand, with React you get much better TypeScript support. Another joint technology is React Native. With React Native you can create native mobile apps with React syntax. So if any of these technologies are of interest to you, maybe that's how you make your choice. If you want to know more and learn these libraries the fun way, we can also dive deeper into React and Vue by building a game. In the description below, I share two links for two more in-depth courses. You can learn how to make a tic-tac-toe game with React or how to make a Minesweeper game with Vue. In these courses, we go through the main patterns in more detail as we code along and create a game. I can't wait to see you there! Thank you for watching. If you got this far, please also leave some feedback in the comments below. This was my first YouTube video, so I appreciate any feedback.